Hello, good afternoon everybody. I am Dr. K. Sabharwal from Sabharwal Hospital, Model Town, Jalandhar. I did my MBBS from Dayanand Medical College and Hospital, Ludhiana and post-graduation in medicine in 1986. Today I am going to talk about hypertension, very relevant topic to in our day-to-day practice. So first of all, I'll like to define what is hypertension. Hypertension basically it is increased pressure in your arteries. When it crosses the normal limit, then we call it as a hypertension. And hypertension, it has got two components, systolic hypertension and diastolic hypertension. The upper one is called systolic and lower one is called diastolic. And both of these blood pressures, they are important in our life. The normal blood pressure, what we call it, is 130/80. Any reading above 130/80 is called as hypertensive. As such, there are no symptoms of hypertension. Blood pressure often goes undetected for many years before the patient lands with the complications of blood pressure. And in very few cases, and that also in severe hypertension, you can have mild headache, early morning headache. So that's why this disease is often termed as or called as silent killer, because the patient has no symptoms and that's why he doesn't go to doctor for checking his for the checkup of the blood pressure. So how do we now how do we detect or diagnose hypertension? It is a very simple procedure. We go to a doctor or even any paramedic like a staff nurse or some other person can see your blood pressure with an instrument like which is called sphygmomanometer. But nowadays we have even digital BP apparatuses which are available online and you can get it from the stores also. You can measure your blood pressure even at your residence without a paramedic also. So this is how we can detect a very dangerous disease and in a very simple way. So what happens if the blood pressure is not treated? So blood pressure, most of the times, because it is a silent disease or it is called a silent killer, most of the patient land up with the complication like the heart problem. Incidence of heart disease, heart problem or heart failure is very very high in these patients, and these patients are very prone to get heart attacks. Then the other vital organ which is involved is brain, and these patients who are uncontrolled with hypertension can have hemiplegia or intracerebral hemorrhage and subdural hemorrhage and so many other complications. Now the other organ which is also very vital organ is the kidney. You can have increased incidence of kidney failure in these patients. And eyes, virtually every vital organ of the brain can be affected with this disease if this disease goes untreated. Now we should know who are the persons who are prone to get hypertension. Hypertension can be primary means that we don't know what is the cause, or it is called idiopathic, or it is essential hypertension. It can be secondary when we know there is some cause, and when we treat or remove that cause, the hypertension, the BP or hypertension, it automatically gets controlled. So, but the commonest cause of hypertension is idiopathic or essential hypertension, where we don't know what is the cause. And who are the people who are more prone to hypertension? Like if there is a family history of hypertension, these people, they are more prone to get hypertension in future. Or a patient who is a chronic alcoholic, chronic smoker and anxious patients, these patients are more prone to get hypertension in future. The other causes, which is called secondary hypertension, these causes, the secondary causes, like if there is some problem in the kidneys, there is some problem in the adrenals, the patient is having high salt intake, or the patient is on some oral hormones, like females who are having these oral contraceptives, these patients can have secondary hypertension. And one more important cause, when there is blockage to the kidneys due to some disease, these patients are also prone to hypertension. But good thing about these patients is that it can be controlled when you try to remove the cause. Now we come to the treatment part. Treatment is with the medications only. So first of all, the first important step is lifestyle modification. Lifestyle modification can control your, or can bring down your mild to moderate blood pressure to a normal level. So first of all, the most important thing is, if you are overweight, you should decrease your weight. If you are a smoker, you should cut down, or you should stop smoking. If you are taking alcohol, you have to stop it, or you can altogether decrease, not more than 2 drinks a day. And then cutting down your salt, you should not add any extra or table salt in your food. And regular exercise is the most important thing. Regular exercise, which means a brisk walking about 30 minutes a day for 5 days a week or 6 days a week. This is the minimum. You can go beyond that also, because exercise decreases your blood pressure and brings a sense of well-being also. Now, what are the precautions that how we can avoid hypertension? Basically, the person who are prone to hypertension, a family, strong family history of hypertension makes a person prone to get hypertension in future. So you should adopt healthy lifestyle, regular walking, keeping the good body weight, and your BMI between 20 and 25, and avoiding fatty foods, avoiding alcohol, smoke. All these things will make you feel better. In the end, I would simply close down with few words saying that you can prevent or control this deadly disease with your lifestyle modification and few simple medicines. Thank you.